A proper road race, and in the true meaning of the word. That was how Mr. Monaco, the late great Graham Hill, once described this iconic event. The cars we drive have come a long way in the intervening half century, but still we race on those same public roads beside the Mediterranean Sea. There's no victory more coveted than that of the Monaco Grand Prix. The prestigious Circuit de Monaco, then. It's not all that dissimilar today to the layout that made its debut almost a century ago. It's 2 miles and 19 corners through the streets of Monte Carlo, and although the average lap speed of around 93 miles per hour is the lowest of the season, the tiny margins for error make it the natural habitat of the safety car. It's race day yet again, and joining me for a chat, Anthony Davidson. And our racers are certainly in for a rough day today. What will you be watching for as they go down into turn one?
Well, the start of the race is always one of the most nerve-wracking parts. You have to hope that everyone is able to get off to a clean start, and this is possibly the trickiest part of the entire race. So many drivers in such a small space, and finding your braking point into turn one as well. It's a testament to the driver's skill that there aren't more incidents.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Parker lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Verstappen, Lewis Hamilton, and Leclerc, Sainz, Norris, Ricciardo, and Pierre Gasly, Vettel, Fernando Alonso, Yuki Tsunoda, and Ocon, Giovinazzi, Stroll, Kimi Raikkonen and George Russell, Mick Schumacher and Nikita Mazepin. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. Somewhere on the ICE, be aware that we will start to see a loss of power. Perez has just posted the fastest lap of the race. This is your final lap of the race. You're leading the pack, P1. Perez behind, less than a second separate you. They're on fresh softs. This is your final lap of the race. Fantastic drive, just fantastic. You deserve that race win.
They've done it then. They've won here in Monaco with an emphatic performance and a victory they can be proud of for years to come. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
It looks like it's time once again to hand out the silverware as the successful drivers make their way to the podium. It was a gritty performance today by Williams, and they've got the race win to prove it. Schumacher increases their championship lead. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Well, there's a lot of incredible driving out there today, Crofty. But if I had to pick someone, it's got to be Sergio Perez. Fantastic driving.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. No change in the top spot, but with today's points, their hold on the lead is getting weaker. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from Red Bull this time out, and they improve their position in the championship. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for the next one.